Hello, dear viewers, and welcome to a new episode of Games and Names. Our sport for this episode is the sport of Jiu-Jitsu, and our featured star guest is Sensei Mohammed Fawzi, who is considered to be the founder of Jiu-Jitsu in Egypt, and he is also the head of the technical committee for the sport of Jiu-Jitsu at the Egyptian Association for the Sport of Judo. So let's get to know more about Jiu-Jitsu in Egypt and about Sensei Mohammed Fawzi in the upcoming minutes of Games and Names.
Jiu-Jitsu is a martial art. It's a self-defense sport. It's an old sport with Indian origin. It's possible to use Jiu-Jitsu to defend oneself even if the opponent happens to be of bigger muscular power or happens to carry a weapon. Jiu-Jitsu has a number of belts that indicate one's perfection of the sport, like the white belt, one for the beginners, and the black belt, an indication for a professional player. The players also wear a vest called the kimono, which is made of light cotton material. If the match ends in a draw, another one is to be scheduled to decide the winner. If one of the players commits a grave violation of the sport's rules, he gets suspended and naturally his opponent wins. Two bodies organize matches and tournaments in the sport of Jiu-Jitsu. They are the International Federation of Jiu-Jitsu, which organizes a World Cup every 4 years. That International Federation was formed in the year 1977. The other federation is a Brazilian federation that oversees the sport, as Brazil has adopted this sport at the moment. Jiu-Jitsu matches are 5 minutes old. They consist of only one round. The match ends with one player forcing the other to surrender, or if a player wins via points. The points are awarded by the main judge and his assistants. Jiu-Jitsu is a martial art. It's a self-defense sport. It's an old sport with Indian origin. It's possible to use Jiu-Jitsu to defend oneself even if the opponent happens to be of bigger muscular power or happens to carry a weapon. Jiu-Jitsu has a number of belts that indicate one's perfection of the sport, like the white belt, one for the beginners, and the black belt, an indication for a professional player. The players also wear a vest called the kimono, which is made of light cotton material. If the match ends in a draw, another one is to be scheduled to decide the winner. If one of the players commits a grave violation of the sport's rules, he gets suspended and naturally his opponent wins. Two bodies organize matches and tournaments in the sport of Jiu-Jitsu. They are the International Federation of Jiu-Jitsu, which organizes a World Cup every 4 years. That International Federation was formed in the year 1977. The other federation is a Brazilian federation that oversees the sport, as Brazil has adopted this sport at the moment. Jiu-Jitsu matches are 5 minutes old. They consist of only one round. The match ends with one player forcing the other to surrender, or if a player wins via points. The points are awarded by the main judge and his assistants. Jiu-Jitsu is a martial art. It's a self-defense sport. It's an old sport with Indian origin. It's possible to use Jiu-Jitsu to defend oneself even if the opponent happens to be of bigger muscular power or happens to carry a weapon. Jiu-Jitsu has a number of belts that indicate one's perfection of the sport, like the white belt, one for the beginners, and the black belt, an indication for a professional player. The players also wear a vest called the kimono, which is made of light cotton material. If the match ends in a draw, another one is to be scheduled to decide the winner. If one of the players commits a grave violation of the sport's rules, he gets suspended and naturally his opponent wins. Two bodies organize matches and tournaments in the sport of Jiu-Jitsu. They are the International Federation of Jiu-Jitsu, which organizes a World Cup every 4 years. That International Federation was formed in the year 1977. The other federation is a Brazilian federation that oversees the sport, as Brazil has adopted this sport at the moment. Jiu-Jitsu matches are 5 minutes old. They consist of only one round. The match ends with one player forcing the other to surrender, or if a player wins via points. The points are awarded by the main judge and his assistants.
I want to thank 9TV International for helping to spread sports in general and specifically Jiu-Jitsu. I'm Captain Mohammed Fawzi. I trained in the police academy for 12 years here in Egypt, and I am considered to be the founder of Jiu-Jitsu in Egypt. The sport was first brought to Egypt in the year 2007. We started organizing competitions in 2009, and we then joined the Judo Association and have a committee there. So we're now on solid ground, and I'm currently the technical director of the sport of Jiu-Jitsu in the Egyptian Judo Association. And I hope that next time we meet, I'm going to tell you that we have an independent association for the sport of Jiu-Jitsu here in Egypt, and I believe that this is where we are heading. Again, I want to thank 9TV International and the officials here in Egypt, and especially Youth and Sports Minister Dr. Ashraf Subhi and Captain Marzu Ali, the head of the Judo Association, for helping in the efforts to spread Jiu-Jitsu in Egypt, and I believe that Jiu-Jitsu has a very bright future ahead in this country. We are achieving our dreams and taking big strides in spreading Jiu-Jitsu in Egypt. And I want to tell you that Abu Dhabi has now entered and sponsored the holding of official Jiu-Jitsu competitions in Egypt. Abu Dhabi is considered to be one of the biggest sponsors for the sport worldwide. And we will be holding in March a big tournament here, either in Cairo Stadium Stadium or in the administrative capital sports complex, and participants from no less than 10 countries will be here. And this is the first time that we are going to hold an Abu Dhabi event here in Egypt, and this is considered a milestone. Jiu-Jitsu is considered as a Brazilian wrestling sport. It is characterized by, depending on throwing, strangling, and holding. The way we mark the points in our sport is a bit complex. It's a bit different from other martial arts. Jiu-Jitsu is called the gentle martial arts sport because we have a message and noble goals. We have the goal of possessing a strong, healthy a society. We want men and women to be able to defend themselves and to have psychological equilibrium and respect for themselves and for society. And again, the sport is taking big strides in Egypt, and athletes from all ages are participating in action. I mean, we have children, we have youth, we have the seniors and the masters as well. Jiu-Jitsu is a sport for all age categories. You can play Jiu-Jitsu starting from 4 years of age until you are over 60. We have seniors competitions and masters competitions for those who are over 60 years of age. So our sport is a sport of peace. It's spread across the country very well at the moment. 22 of the 29 governorates now practice jiu-jitsu, and our goal, of course, is to make it 29 out of 29. Local tournament every 4 months for all age categories. We have a competition for under 16, different competitions for different age, youth age categories, and one for the masters. So we have four local tournaments every year, and our goal now is to hold two or three international tournaments per year. Since we began the holding of competitions in Egypt in Jiu-Jitsu in 2009, we have organized 50 tournaments, and we are planning for an exponential increase of the holding of events in the near future. Well, the EGB Tour, the official sponsor for the sport worldwide, the tour that covers more than 55 countries worldwide, will be here in Egypt in March for the big Abu Dhabi tournament, which will be held here in Egypt in Cairo in March. And this is a milestone for us, and the plan is to get more EGB Tour events here in Egypt every year. We want three competitions every year, three EGB Tour competitions per year. That is our goal, and we plan to cover all of the country's governorates and not just Cairo. A key element for success in our sport is for the athlete to love the sport and sports in general, and of course to be physically ready and fit. But we also have competitions for people with special abilities, and this is something that we really cherish in our sport. We even had a show that we presented before His Excellency the President for athletes with special abilities, and again, this is something that we cherish very much. Flexibility, elasticity, and respect, IQ are very important elements in our sport. We have a lot of champions here in Egypt, international champions, and of course local ones. I'm not gonna name anyone because we have a lot of them, so I don't want to forget anyone, but we have a lot of kids, youth, and senior champions in different age categories. No less than 20 have won international competitions and have medals, while locally in each governorate we have really a number of local champions, no less than 100 all over the country, and especially in the governorates of Cairo, Giza, Alexandria, Dakhleya, Port Said, Suez, Ismailia. and Dumyat. I don't want to forget Dumyat because we have Captain Tarek Matar, a world champion who lives in the United Arab Emirates, and he comes from Dumyat. So I have to mention Dumyat or Damietta. We have a higher committee at the Jiu-Jitsu Association, of course, which is part of the Judo Association, and it is the one tasked with selecting national teams in different age categories. And this is how it goes. I mean, we have national championships for each age category in the children's age categories. And so we get the first three from each competition, and then we continue with more qualifiers, because to form the team, you have a two-year gap. So you have the under 8, under 10, under 12, under 14, under 16, under 18, and so on. When we get to the Masters, the gap would become 5 years. So we have like Masters 1 from 30 to 35, Masters 2 from 35 to 40, Masters 3 from 40 to 45, and so on. And so this is how we form our national teams. Again, I want to thank Nile TV and all of the TV channels that have helped sponsor and cover our sport, because this is a big help in the efforts to spread the sport across Egypt. I really care about raising sports awareness among society and amongst the families of the athletes. And I want to tell parents, you know, that jiu-jitsu is very good for your children. It actually raises IQ, in my belief. It's just like chess. We recommend really that children practice this sport. I mean, you could be physically average and still win and defeat your opponents because of the smart tactics that you practice. Also, jiu-jitsu really makes you good at biomechanics, because we play the sport standing on our backs, on our faces, on our sides. So it really teaches you a lot of skills and helps your muscles grow. Now, we are going to have the upcoming GBE tournament here in Cairo in March, and the Abu Dhabi tournament will be organized here in Egypt. And my goal is to see Egypt just like the UAE, a leader in the sport of jiu-jitsu worldwide. We are very well known on the Arab and African scenes and also internationally. Well, we dream of getting the status that the UAE is getting in this sport, being the leader in this sport. We also want to be a leader. I also dream about having an audience and spectators for jiu-jitsu just like those in football. I mean, that's a legitimate dream. I know it's far-fetched, but it's still legitimate to dream. Again, the EGB Tour will be here in March. We are also now regularly getting experts from Germany and France to teach our coaches and to give courses to our coaches, and also the referees and judges in the sport. So we are really making big strides in that regard. The game is being spread very well in the country. I mean, previously we had one or two teams only in each governorate. Now we have at least five and six teams in every governorate. So we are moving on the right track. We are also having MMA players joining our sport. They love our sport. They really respect it. It is a very distinct sport, the sport of jiu-jitsu, with a very bright future in Egypt, God willing.